Yeah, like right now, me talking into this isn't going over air, but theoretically it should go over the screen. Let me make sure I have the right microphone.
Well, like in, on the thing. Yeah. Yeah.
Sports coverage on
Okay.
New York sports fan, The Score, 1260. Welcome to your home for local sports in Syracuse. Outside the Box Score with Mark Rowlands starts right now.
You like Huey Lewis in the news? Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Outside the Box Score with me, Mark Rowlands, your home for local sports in Syracuse right here on The Score 1260. We're going to have a great show for you today. I've got a good friend of mine in studio. We were just talking about Huey Lewis in the news before the show started, so I had to play it. Josh Boehme, my co-host on the Hot Stove podcast, good friend of mine from SUNY Oswego. Josh, how we doing?
Great, Mark. Thanks for having me on.
There we go.
Thanks for having me on, Mark.
Yeah, glad to have you here. It's interesting. I don't think I've ever told this story on this show before. Mm-hmm. I recently told it on the Manchild show, but this show originated with me and you.
That's right.
It's funny how different the show is now from what it was then. We started Outside the Box Score. Was a gambling show that we did originally on an app called Colorcast, which stinks.
Now defunct.
Is it defunct?
I think it's still around.
But we started doing it there, and then we took it to Twitter for a while, and we were using Twitter Spaces to do this show. And it was like the same time slot. It was Saturdays at like 11 a.m.
whenever we woke up.
essentially. But because we wanted to get the wanted to give our college football picks for that day.
Yeah.
And, you know, most of the games started noon, so we started the show at 11 so we could get a look at the college football slate. But, yeah, I mean, this is a throwback edition of Outside the Box Score, except this time on the airwaves of the Score 1260.
Right. Now you're getting paid for it.
I'm getting paid for it.
That was the whole thing. There it is.
So today's show is probably going to be a little bit different than the ones I normally do. If you've ever listened to the Hot Stove podcast or anything Josh and I have done in the past, usually it devolves into random movie quotes and a bunch of crap that maybe you want to listen to, maybe you don't. We'll see how the rest of this show goes. We will, of course, talk about some of the local sports. There's a lot of things going on. The Syracuse women's lacrosse team sadly losing in the Final Four last night. They remain, I saw Brent Axe said this on Twitter, remain the best women's lacrosse program to not win a national championship. They still don't have one. They're going to get one. I know they will. This team is too good. They're way too good, even though they're losing their best player, Megan Tyrell. But that's beside the point. So we'll talk about that. We've got high school sectionals going on. We're going to take a look at that as well. It's going to be a really good show. It's going to be a lot of fun. Like I said, I teased this on the Manchild show yesterday. Might be the most fun show we have. I mean, when the two of us get together, it's always chaos.
Really setting this thing up here. I hope I can, you know.
You'll perform. Yeah. And old radio pro with our before. We had a show. Before Hot Stove was a podcast, we were on WNYO. We had 2 hours every Saturday. Was that
piece of cake?
Was that at 11 too?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, 1 or 12 to 2.
I think it might have been 11 to 1. So you're a pro at doing radio at 11 a.m. on a Saturday.
Radio hours.
Peak radio. Absolutely. This is when everyone's listening. This is exactly the time slot you want. Hey, I love this time slot personally. It's great. I don't have to wake up that early. I just roll in and hang out with you until lunchtime, and then you can go about the rest of your day.
And then never talk again. We only talk with mics in front of us.
Yeah. We've never had a conversation.
I don't like to hang out with
it.
You in person.
No, you're.
I thought I could zoom in today Is it? He said, I got to be here. I was like, I guess I'll still do
fine,
it.
Fine, I yeah. guess. Yeah. No, we don't golf together, right? We've never hung out. What we're going to do is we're going to take a timeout, get the first break out of the way. We'll come back. We'll talk about all sorts of things. You're listening to Outside the Box Score with me, Mark Rowlands, your home for local sports in Syracuse, right here on the Score 1260.
Do you have household appliances laying around? Maybe some aluminum, copper, and brass? Turn the...
Yeah, the Syracuse Cross, I'll play dumb and be like, what happened? I'm a heartbreaker. And you can just talk about it. I don't know anything.
Yeah, you saw the end of the game, right? Or saw the highlights at least. So we'll talk about that. Hi everybody. We figured out how to get the studio mics on the stream.
Right.
So now you can actually hear us during breaks, unlike last week. did I tell you about that?
No.
Yeah. Also, if you're gonna talk, you're still.
I still got talking to you. Yeah.
Last week I was streaming and I didn't find out until the last break that
nobody heard
the studio audio was going through. So I'm just talking because I think the camera microphone's picking it up.
Yeah.
And it wasn't. It was just commercials.
Oh.
And it was the last break. One of the watchers was like, hey, you know, can't hear you.
Yeah.
And I'm like, oh.
You're just talking to nobody. You're
yeah.
Like, hey, you know, this is it.
They,
guys,
they couldn't hear a word I was saying.
Mm. Well, that's what it was different when you did the Barstool one. It was probably the last one I watched
mm-hmm.
on there. And you could hear them just through whatever. It
was yeah, it was
camera,
the camera.
Like,
yeah.
So I was like, oh, it's a little off. But then I'd have it on my phone to actually listen to the audio
mm-hmm.
better, but then just watch you guys.
Yeah.
And
that's
yeah,
why I, when I posted the video on YouTube, that's mm-hmm. why I took the audio from air.
You spliced it?
Yeah, I spliced,
it.
I spliced it.
It's
can edit, you know, it's no big deal.
Yeah.
And, but yeah, I took the audio from air and. Nice. Put it in there, and why are headphones so damn loud? But yeah, so now we can do this. It's great.
Nice.
It sounds so much better.
Yeah, I mean, people can actually hear us. Anybody in the chat right now?
Not in the chat right now. Say hello if you are in the chat.
On,
we've got a couple of viewers. Jesus.
Oh, Junior? No, he's a big boy. Don't worry about it.
Yeah, I'm not worried about that. But, yeah, we got a couple of viewers right now, so say hello in the chat. We are also live on the newly minted Score 1260 YouTube
mm-hmm.
channel.
Somebody was pumped up about that on Twitter, I saw.
Yeah, which Jim should be in here. Jim, where are you?
Jim!
Jim! I know you're out there, Jim. Get the stream up on YouTube
sure,
on my phone.
Sure.
Oh, yeah, a couple of subscribers to the Score already. Beautiful, beautiful.
So you gonna, did you tell them that about the boxing thing or no?
No, I'll talk about that when we come back, yeah.
Gotcha.
I did say that I'm going to be producing some recorded content.
I saw that, yeah.
Yeah, we'll talk about that when I come back. It's going to be a lot of fun.
You got to get another intern in here. I'm telling you, you just got to
I'm trying.
Are you really?
Yeah, I might have another one soon.
Can they get credit? Did they get credit for the last guy? Or it's just
no.
like experience.
Yeah,
that's fine.
That's fine.
That's all they need anyway.
Yeah.
It's over the summer. You'll find someone living in Syracuse, either at
yeah.
SU or Oswego,
mm-hmm.
that's going to do it.
Yeah. So, yeah, I'll have another intern at some point. I want to get one because talking into the void.
Yeah.
Just alone for an hour is kind of a pain in the
yeah.
ass.
It's a little weird probably, yeah.
Yeah, right. That's why I like so much when I get callers, which, oh, yeah, I'll have to open up the phone line. So let me come back to. That's why I like getting callers so much because it's like, oh, people are listening. Great.
It's, yeah.
Then the Twitch chat, but
it's a different feel. It's bringing me back to Town A days where I'm just like, yeah, that's
yeah.
a solo show. I actually didn't like guests on it.
Yeah.
It was better to do alone because
mm-hmm.
especially doing a character like that.
Yeah. You
thing.
Were doing a bit.
Yeah,
so
yeah, I was doing a whole, and like guests would try and talk to me as if I was me and I'd just be rude or whatever.
Yeah.
And they were like, what is this guy doing? I'm like, yeah, I don't like, you guys don't get it. Get out of here.
I really do wish we were coming out of college in the era of the shock jock.
I would have killed it.
You would have been
I would have
so good.
Yeah. I would have dominated.
All right.
But now that's bad.
Yeah. Now it's bad. All
no
right.
good.
And we're back outside the box score with me, Mark Rowlands, right here on the Score 1260, your home for local sports in Syracuse. Joined by a good friend of mine, Josh Boehme, going back to the SUNY Oswego days. Very excited to have him in studio. We've got a lot of things that we're going to talk about today. Josh just reminded me during the break, which if you want to hear our conversations during the break, by the way, you can tune in on Twitch and the Score 1260's new YouTube channel. Mm-hmm. We're live there right now. It's got the studio audio. It's great. You can catch us during the break, see what we talk about.
Oh, yeah.
And we were just talking about during the break, he reminded me to tell you guys that there's going to be some content coming on the Score YouTube channel fairly soon. In a couple weeks, June 8th to 11th, I will be in lovely Canastota and Verona, New York, for the Boxing Hall of Fame induction ceremony. I'll be hopefully getting to interview some of the people that are there. I'll be producing a lot of content from there, so be on the lookout for that. Show will still be on Saturday that week, so I'll still be
working double.
Yeah, working double. I'll come in, do the show from 11 to 12, then drive out to Turning Stone.
Any big name getting inducted this year? Who's the biggest guy?
The induction class this year isn't great, especially compared to last year.
Last year was a big one.
Yeah, I mean, last year was Floyd and Andre Ware and the oh my God, why am I drawing a blank? The Klitschko brothers, and it was a huge class. I'm going to look up the class again this year because there's one person that I'm thinking of, and I can't remember. Oh, Tim Bradley Jr. is going in.
Okay.
Carl Frock and Rafael Marquez. Alicia Ashley, Laura Serrano are the women going in. Mm. So it's gonna be a great weekend. They do an awesome job out there. I went last year with our mutual friend Zach Nunez, not as a credentialed member of the media, but just
we wanted
to spend a weekend at the Turning Stone. And so we went to the fights on Friday night. I'll be going to the fights as well. Nice. Those are an absolute blast.
Yeah.
Seeing boxing in person is so much fun. I had never been to a fight before.
Is it a pretty big venue out there for the
No.
boxing? So it's got to be nicer then too.
Yeah, it's a pretty small, intimate venue. It's really, really nice. I mean, what it doesn't have in size, it certainly makes up for in quality of venue. It's a really great venue. And so I'll be going to those. I'm very excited. One of the guests this year, not getting inducted, but he's going to be around, and I want to get an interview with him, is my favorite boxer of all time.
Who's that?
Irish Mickey Ward.
Mickey Ward?
Mickey Ward is going to be there.
There's a movie about that
The
guy,
Fighter.
Right? Yeah, okay.
Yeah, with Mark Wahlberg and Christian Bale.
Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
So that's about him and his brother/trainer, Dickie Englund. And, yeah, so Mickey Ward's going to be there, my favorite fighter. If you've never seen, you can find them all on YouTube. His trilogy of fights with Arturo Gatti, specifically the first one, best fight I've ever seen. It's unreal. Talk about a slugfest. Both the guys went to the hospital after the first and third fights.
The second one was a dud. Nobody had to go to the hospital.
Second one's also a great fight, but no one had to go to the hospital. And, it's an absolute slugfest. It is one of the most exciting fights you'll ever see.
Did it go 12?
Oh, yeah. All three, or the first and third go 12. The second one might have only gone 8.
Okay. Grudge match on the third, then?
Yeah.
I take it?
Yeah. Ward wins the first. Gatti wins the second. Gatti wins the third.
Okay.
That's the thing. Mickey Ward, you know, they made the movie and that trilogy of fights. Not a super successful boxing career.
Sure.
But just the most iron of chins. There's one point in the first fight where Gatti hits him with a ridiculous combination. Like,
okay.
You know, seven straight power punches. Like, and Ward just backs up, shrugs his shoulders, and like sort of eggs him on. And the round ends, and Gatti goes back to his corner and says, I don't know what else I can do. It's absolutely wild.
Jeez.
Mm-hmm. And like I said, they're all on YouTube. I highly recommend at least watching the first one.
Yeah.
Because it is... Ward only got knocked down once in the entire fight, and that was a low blow. So it didn't even count.
So he just does iron chin.
Iron
Irish
chin.
Hero.
Yes. Irish Mickey Ward from Lowell, Massachusetts. And...
Oh, yeah.
He's so much fun to watch, and I hope I get the chance to have a conversation with him and bring that to you guys. I would love to record it and post it, but even if I can't and just get to meet the guy, because he's been my favorite fighter for years, it's going to be a lot of fun. Be on the lookout for a lot of content coming from that. live from both the Turning Stone and the Boxing Hall of Fame in Canastota. That's where all the interviews are to be conducted, or at the Boxing Hall of Fame. So be pretty cool. Maybe talk to a couple guys that, you know, stand right next to the cast of their fist. Do you know that's what they do there?
No.
You know, like Baseball Hall of Fame has the plaques, and they have the busts at the Football Hall of Fame.
They get gloves? Like,
no, it's their fist. It's not a glove. It is an actual iron cast of the person's fist.
I did not know that.
It's so cool.
Who's got the big? There's got to be like some guy with like the biggest sledgehammer fist that's there.
Yeah, I don't even know who that would be. I feel like Tyson's got a big hand.
Yeah. But it also kind of doesn't matter in boxing, right? I mean,
no, you got the gloves. Yeah.
So it doesn't really matter. But I'm sure that's got to be a fun thing to just see the differences in guys.
We got Jim in the chat. He says, "What's going on? So much O-Town in the house there." He is a he lives in Oswego.
Oh, nice.
He's Oswego guy, always talking Oswego sports with him. So, nice. Yeah, a lot of Oswego represented in the studio right now.
Oh, yeah.
It's like when Steve was here, and it's just a couple of Oswego boys. O-Town graduate in 1985. So, there we go.
It is.
He knows it. He loves it. We love Oswego. We had a lot of fun there. yes, he said, yes, I'm old. Come on, Jimmy.
That ain't bad.
Yeah, that's not too bad at all. But you were a year before me, right? Were you 2020?
Yeah, 2019.
19, okay, so 2 years before me. I don't know why I thought you were
there every year.
Yeah, like, after you graduated is when you started coming on Hot Stove. That's right.
That's right, yeah. The entire next year, I came up every weekend to do the show.
Yeah.
Well, and, you know, other things, but yeah, I was other there
things,
a lot.
Yes. Yeah, that's right. Always remember, getting old beats the alternative, he says. Fair point.
Good point.
He's also on YouTube. He's commenting from both Twitch and YouTube.
Everywhere.
The madman, Jim. We love him. So we do have the YouTube channel now. So make sure to check that out. Subscribe to the YouTube channel. We'll be live there every week as well as Twitch. No longer live on Twitter. It's a lot. And it was kind of a pain because I couldn't see the comments from Twitter. If people were leaving them for whatever reason, I use StreamYard.
Yeah.
They don't show up on StreamYard through Twitter. So I was like, it'll be better to have Twitch and YouTube going.
That way we
can see all of the comments.
Yep.
But it's going to be a great weekend in Canastota. I'm very excited. I'm a big boxing fan.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be awesome. You should check it out one of these years. Especially go to the fights at least.
Get an extra pass. I'll come down. I'll be your video guy. I'll shoot video for you. There you go.
I would have loved to try to get multiple passes, but it's
probably
through the station, and it's like, okay, I can't.
I got you.
Yeah. If you were employed here, we'll say you're an intern. We'll say you're an intern, even though the deadline to apply for passes was 2 weeks ago. We'll say you're an intern. We'll try to get you one. This is my new intern, Josh Boehme. He's going to come in once every 3 months whenever I need him. Let's talk about the Syracuse lacrosse game from last night, because this is an absolute heartbreaker. Boston College has been a thorn in the side of Syracuse lacrosse all year, and looked like the team was well on their way to their first national championship. Turns out they're not. They give up 3 goals in the fourth quarter. Same thing. Hashtag blame the refs last night.
Could be. I saw that free shot. What do they call it in lacrosse? We have free.
Yeah, I don't
shooter,
even.
Free shooter.
Free
shot.
Shooter.
There it is. Had one 10 yards out. Free shooter. Go get him.
Yeah, that was brutal.
Yeah, I mean, they led the entire game almost.
Mm-hmm.
They had it.
Pretty much the entire game. Yeah, they were up 3-2 after one.
Mm-hmm.
And then it was tied up after two at 4 apiece. They were up 7-5 going into the fourth quarter.
Yep.
They lose 8-7. Fourth quarter defense, free position. Thank you, Jim.
Thanks, Jim.
Fourth quarter defense has not been this team's strong suit, specifically against Boston College. And it's, like I said, they've been a thorn in our side all year. Would have been tough going up against a Northwestern team that absolutely demolished Denver yesterday. I didn't see the very end of the game, but the last score I saw was 15-5 with like 2 minutes left.
Not a lot of highlights there. Yeah.
Yeah. It was absolute drubbing by Northwestern against Denver yesterday, but would have been a tough matchup. But God, this team seemed like they had the talent to go all the way, and they certainly had the talent. That's not in question. Megan Tyrell, Megan Carney, Emma Tyrell, all of the it was Emily Weicker described as on Syracuse.com as it's the seven weapons that Syracuse has. Count them, seven.
Yeah.
That's hard to overcome if you're any other team, but.
What's the team look like next year?
I know Tyrell is gone.
Okay.
Megan Tyrell, that is. Emma yep. will still be around. She's the younger sister. Megan Carney will be leaving as well. So the two Megans that really led the team in scoring this year are both yep. going to be gone. But Coach Trainer has done a great job with this program since taking over for Gary Gate, who of course moved over to the men's program.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not worried about them moving forward. You still got Emma Ward as well, Olivia Adamson.
Yep.
There's a lot of talent on this team. And listen, I wouldn't be surprised if they made another run in a national title next year. This program is in such a great state right now yep. with the coach and all of the talent. So they're going to be fine. It's just, it sucks. I was rooting for yeah. another national championship in Syracuse athletics because we've got a, you know, one in the last year. We had the soccer team.
Right.
So it would have been nice to have another one, but they're still fighting. There's still a chance of winning a national championship. Let me double check that first, actually, because I think they were competing today. So I'm gonna double check that. The women's rowing team.
Okay.
Yes, the women's rowing team.
Hey, it's a sport.
It is a NCAA sport.
Lord knows I can't do it.
The varsity four finished first place in the semifinal.
Okay.
So NCAA finals racing for all three boats tomorrow. So the varsity four, the varsity eight, and both varsity eight, the first and second varsity eight teams.
Okay.
So tomorrow, Syracuse women's rowing still has a shot at taking home a national championship.
One year ain't bad.
I'll take it. You know, soccer, lacrosse, women's rowing. Mm. I don't care what it is. I'll take it. See, rowing equals underrated pain afterwards, maybe? Probably. I mean, that seems like a very physically demanding sport.
Yeah, I couldn't imagine the back, especially.
The back, the shoulders.
Yeah, a lot of strength.
Yeah, a lot of trap strength required. You of course, have the best traps in the game. So.
I do, especially for a big fella. I mean,
the traps are unbelievable.
Yeah, we can have views over here on the Twitter side. I'll take it off. Let's do it. Let's show them something.
They can just check out any of our Hot Stove After Dark episodes that you do entirely shirtless all the time.
That's right.
Most recent one, we were just naming dudes. That was a lot of fun.
Yeah, good time.
Do we still have a podcast?
I don't think so. I think it's gone. Which, honestly, at this point, who cares?
We had
a radio show. We've evolved from it. You have a radio show now. It's kind of the goal anyways, mm-hmm. right? I mean, what do we need to do? You just cycle through us every so often. And
yeah, we'll get Nunez here at some point.
Yeah, sure. Bring him on.
I doubt Austin would want to make an appearance, but...
But that's fine. It's not his thing.
It's not his thing. He's got a big boy job. So
speaking about Syracuse athletics, Mark Wilson on. Did you see the Syracuse made a little bit of buzz at the ACC baseball tournament over the weekend?
Yes, I did see that. I thought
figured you would.
I thought about interviewing one of those guys.
You could reach out to the kid probably that goes here.
I didn't end up reaching out to him, but I did think about it. I might get him on next week if. He's available because I'm assuming he's still at the ACC tournament.
Yeah.
Like Jim says, wait, SU has a baseball team. No, that's the thing.
Yeah.
So this guy went to the ACC baseball tournament. Him and it was two guys, but
yep.
one of them was a father and son, and the son is a student at SU. And Syracuse does have a club baseball team.
I had the
president on, Connor Burke, a good friend of mine, had him mm-hmm. on the show a few weeks ago, but they do not have a Division I NCAA baseball team, which I have always said is a travesty. The fact that they don't have a baseball or a golf team, specifically golf, because they own a golf course.
I've seen it. I was going to tell you, when I came in last, I was going to ask because it's right behind campus. I was like, is that their golf? That's theirs. They own
No, it. Not that one.
Okay. That makes no sense.
Yeah, it's not close. Right behind. Yeah, it's pretty close. It's on a... I can't think of the name of the street that Drumlins is on. But, they own a golf course called Drumlins.
Okay.
There's a private side and a public side. It's, you know, two courses.
And they don't have a golf team.
Mm. Despite the fact they own a golf course.
The other sports. There you go.
Apparently. If you're – yeah, you probably never played it, did you?
What's that?
Drumlins.
No.
Yeah, you could have played it for free.
As an SU student?
Yeah.
Maybe I'll still try and go. I just graduated. I'll go.
Yeah, you.
I'll go.
Yeah,
I got my card.
Yeah, if you've still got your student ID. Oh, you don't have a student ID.
I'll bring my diploma. Does that get me in? Hey.
But all SU students get to walk there for free. You have to pay for a cart, but
I'll buy a cart.
Yeah.
I don't do a lot of walking.
Yeah.
I don't get out much.
make sure that it's kind of a hilly course. Make sure you're in the cart alone.
damn it. I mean, that, come on.
And listen, that was one of the funniest things I've ever seen.
Bad cart. I'm not that fat. I don't know. I don't know why that happened.
It wasn't a great golf cart. We were golfing a couple weeks ago. It was a steep hill. Josh may or may not have had to get out of the cart for the cart to make it up the hill. But it's fine.
I should sue the cart. I'm going after the course for emotional damages. It wasn't that bad. I don't understand it. I've never had that happen. My father is larger than I am.
Yes.
We drive in plenty of golf carts together.
Yeah.
We've driven in golf carts together. Never happened.
No, it was kind of an old cart. It wasn't a great cart.
Yeah.
I had to bring it up at least once.
We put some poundage on a golf cart before. Never.
Never.
This is crazy. It was asinine. Can I say that?
Yeah. Asinine's a word. Yeah.
Yeah.
We've got a... But anyway, so these two guys go to the ACC baseball tournament wearing nothing but SU gear.
Mm-hmm.
And they claim to be the biggest SU baseball fans in the world. And so they just go to college baseball games representing Syracuse
mm-hmm.
as a form of like, yeah, Syracuse should have a baseball team. And this is a take I've had for years. And I do want to talk to those guys at some point because I think that's a very interesting conversation.
Kind of blew up online.
It did. I mean, they met... Steven Scotch.
Yep.
I think it's pronounced Scotch. I'm going to look that up real quick.
I think you're right.
He has the pronunciation on his Twitter bio.
The kid, too, who goes to SU right now, mm-hmm. love his Twitter bio. He said that he's the walking parlay. And by that, he means that anytime you see him, like he was sitting there with the Syracuse orange baseball jersey
yeah.
with a Tar Heels shirt on
yep.
and a Yankees hat.
Mm-hmm.
The walking parlay.
Yeah,
anytime. And I'm representing multiple sports.
He got some crap for that online, too. I saw a couple of SU people like, what's this guy doing? Like, you know, that didn't know the story. They're just like, why is he wearing a UNC jersey and an SU shirt? Like,
it doesn't make sense, but if you get the joke, it's a fun bit. But I also don't get it either.
Yeah, but yeah, this guy seems awesome, and they just go around supporting SU baseball that doesn't exist. But shout out the SU club team who
it's pretty
did
good,
pretty well,
right? Like they were saying, the club team's actually
oh,
pretty
yeah.
good.
They were fifth in the country at one point, and it went to they lost to Cortland in regionals, so
okay.
they didn't move on past that. But yeah, they had a chance to play in the national tournament and stuff like that. They're damn good.
If they put an ounce of effort into recruiting for their baseball team, it could be probably
oh, yeah.
compete with other D1 programs.
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of good baseball talent around here.
Yeah.
I mean, people that would go there and that's the thing. They had a baseball team.
Mm-hmm.
I know multiple people that played for the SU baseball team back in like the 60s and 70s.
Okay.
They just don't anymore.
I don't get it.
Yeah, I don't either. So it's a school that had a baseball team at one point,
it's
and
not
now
like
it does.
They're running low on the funds over there.
Yeah,
I mean, what are we talking about?
Plenty of money.
Got that degree.
Yeah,
I'm on the baseball team.
Yeah, they can field a baseball team, but so shout out those guys. Those guys are awesome.
Yep.
Big fan of them. And yeah, so you should have a baseball team, but support the club team until they get a actual Division I
mm-hmm.
team, which I hope they will eventually. Can of worms, what sport goes away if they add baseball? That's the question.
Mm.
Now it's,
can you only have X amount?
Well, it's a Title IX thing. It's having the same amount of women's sports as men's, but they have a softball team.
Oh, but maybe they're missing in somewhere else.
I
haven't looked it up.
Let's see. Actually, we can.
Because it is an interesting, like, what men's sport would you drop?
Yeah. So on Cuse.com, when you go to men's sports, they have basketball, cross country, football, lacrosse, rowing, soccer, and track. So
okay.
those are the men's sports. Women's sports. Basketball, cross country, field hockey, ice hockey, lacrosse, rowing, soccer, softball, tennis, track, and volleyball. They have way more women's sports than they have.
There it is. Add it up. No need. No need to drop them.
Yeah. So add baseball.
Did they say they have a women's tennis, but no men's tennis? Is that?
Women's tennis, yes. Yeah.
Okay.
Again, strange.
Yeah. Love the women's sports. Go for it. But yeah, it sounds like.
It's also scholarship numbers. Football.
That's true.
Yeah, a lot of scholarships on the football team.
Especially these days, they're trying to really promote the football team.
Yeah.
Probably its best season they just had in a long time. So.
Yeah, and they went 500.
But the 6-0 start got some national cred. You got up as high as, what, 15th? 16th in the nation? It was upper.
Yeah,
ranked,
I think
sure.
It was 18th.
Okay.
If I remember correctly.
That Clemson
but
game was a heartbreaker as well.
Absolutely brutal. Ruins, but. Yeah. Absolutely brutal. Mm-hmm. But anyway, that's add a baseball and a golf team. That's my plea to SU.
There it is.
Add baseball and golf. We're going to take a timeout. Mm-hmm. Like I said, if you want to hear what Josh and I talk about during the break, who knows what it could be, you can go over to Twitch or YouTube. Subscribe on YouTube. The channel is called The Score 1260. My Twitch account, twitch.tv/box_score_WSKO. Those are both linked on my Twitter as well with my most recent tweet if you want to check that out, marker_box. Quick timeout. We'll be back outside the box score with me, Mark Rowlands, right here on The Score 1260, your home for local sports in Syracuse.
They were like, yeah, what's, they were like, some dude, like, yelled, like, very loudly, like, did you hear that? And I was like, no, I don't, like, it's very loud or whatever. And they're like, yeah, but, like, we were yelling your name, and, like, somebody else, there was a man in the crowd who yelled your name. And I was like, it must have been Pat.
It was probably Pat. Yeah.
Like, and then, because I saw his pictures about it. I didn't tell him yet. Or I'm like, yeah, I think that was Pat. Thanks for the rep. There it is,
yeah,
Pat,
it was probably Pat. Is today just too perfect of a weather day to play golf? Today's a golf day.
It's a great day.
It's absolutely a golf
day.
Great day
to play golf.
Yeah. Tomorrow's going to be great, too. I'm playing tomorrow. But
I might try. I mean, the other thing about the tee times out there, though, they're never booked. People are wide open. Like, people don't play golf, because I think it is, like, the private courses. So, if you're a golfer out there, you just buy the country club membership or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, I've gone out, especially me, I go golfing break of dawn.
Yeah.
Because, one, it's easy for the gal. You go out in the morning, you're home before she wakes up. And then it's easy. I like getting golf. Not that I got to get it out of the way, but I don't want golf to consume my entire day.
Yeah.
As much as I love golf, if you golf at 12 o'clock, it's pretty much in the morning. You're like, okay, I wake up breakfast before golf, and then I'm golfing till 5, and then it's like dinner, sleep. Like, it's just too much golf for me. Too much oriented around golf. But
yeah, I feel that.
Some days. I mean, the day we did it worked out great.
Yeah.
Whenever that was 12 o'clock. Or
yeah, that was
2
like an
o'clock.
Yeah, that was a 1:30 tee time, I think.
Which is fine. I had a morning.
Yeah.
And then it's a weekday too. Weekends are a little different.
Yeah.
But
yeah, weekday it's a little different.
Yeah.
9 holes is perfect. If I'm walking, love walking 9.
Yes.
But take you 2 hours to play 9?
If you're walking, I could see it.
Yeah.
I mean, if you're like behind if you're walking 9 and nobody's letting you pass them, 2 hours sounds about right. Yeah.
Jim, what courses do you play out there? Because I was a Tamarack
What's
guy.
I love Tamarack. What's the place that we played that Stone Ridge?
Stone Creek.
Yeah, I like that.
Battle Island. Yeah, we've played there.
Okay.
Yep.
Is that near Fulton?
Yeah, that's the one in Fulton. Remember we played there? It was like a horrible day.
Oh, yeah. The sea was angry that day.
Yeah, it was 45 with 35 mile an hour winds. It was brutal.
Yeah. Jim, you know any courses out in Utica? You know, Jim? Anyway,
yeah. Does anyone know any courses out of Utica that we can
somebody.
Tell Josh? Staying in Rome for a little while. Battle Island does have. It is a very well kept course.
It was good, even in the crap that we played in.
You said Rome Country Club.
Yep, been there. Thanks, Jim. Not that you wouldn't know.
No,
that,
he wouldn't have known that. But
I do like that place a lot. I've been there. That's like the one place I've been, and then I went to a driving range next to like a par 3 course, which looked fine, like walkable.
Yeah.
But That is actually, that's nice that he said Rome Country Club out of Utica to be like, yeah, go to Rome Country Club.
Yeah.
That's a nice pull. Yeah.
Yeah. Good pull.
Which is nice. Well, maybe that's it. Maybe I just go back to the RCC.
Yeah. It can't go wrong. Happens.
Yeah.
If you liked it, I mean,
it's
why not?
It's cheap. I liked it. I'll play it 10 times. Yeah.
Play it every day.
Switch it up. Yeah. Screw it. I keep getting emails about my, you know, Monroe password to change. And I'm like, I'm dead. Can I delete it? Who? Why haven't you deleted me out of the system? You fired me.
Yeah.
Kind of. Laid off. You laid me off. Get me out of here.
You outsourced me.
You did. You hired Indians for my job. It's not even rape. That's just what happened.
Yeah, it's just what happened.
Just
they,
matter of fact.
Yeah,
I
they
was
just
outsourced to India.
Yeah. That's got to be a wild feeling.
Yeah. Especially when your father does it. It's great.
Yeah.
Every father's dream, lay off their kids.
And we're back outside the box score with me, Mark Rowlands, right here on the Score 1260, your home for local sports in Syracuse. Josh, if you go over to the Twitch chat, you'll actually see a link that Jim sent about golf courses to play in Utica.
Thanks, Jim.
So there you go. Yeah, he said he's only played Rome Country Club, so that's why he recommended that one to you.
Okay.
It's the only one he's played. Let's take a look around the world of high school sports for a second. Mm-hmm. We've got sectionals going on right now in lacrosse, baseball, pretty much everything in terms of spring sports. West Hill boys lacrosse, we talked to Luke Gilmartin a while back for the West Hill basketball team. He's also the star of the lacrosse team. They beat New Hartford in the semifinals 9-8 yesterday. Looks like Luke had 3 goals and an assist. Charlie DeMore, a couple of goals. So very good all-around game for West Hill lacrosse. They're 13-4 on the season, moving into the finals of the sectional championship. Marcellus beating Lafayette Onondaga Central yesterday. Baldwinsville beating my Syracuse lacrosse team. They're 10-8 on the year. Baldwinsville's 15-2. That one was 17-4.
Mm.
So not the best showing from
shellacking. Yeah.
It's a shellacking. But shout out Tyler Hale, one of the goals scored for Syracuse. Work with him over at Bellevue. So.
Hey.
Good job, Tyler. Owen Burns, another one of the bag boys, tossed in an assist. So my buddy's doing good things, getting in the points column. But 17-4. Syracuse will not be advancing. Baldwinsville will be going into the Class A finals in boys lacrosse. They're going to take on Liverpool, who beat CNS. West Hill, by the way, in the Class C finals will be facing off against Jamesville DeWitt, who beat Homer 14-9 yesterday. Today, a lot of baseball games in sectionals. Yeah, a lot of ball going on. We've got Skinny Alice and Cortland at 1 p.m. in the Class B semifinal. Same with Weedsport. They're playing at Bishop Ludden in the Class C semifinal. In terms of Class A, Indian River taking on Jamesville DeWitt and East Syracuse Manoa facing off with New Hartford. I got to check and see the Class AA. I want to see. Is that tomorrow? Yes, the finals for Class AA are tomorrow, Liverpool at CBA. So that's at 6 p.m. tomorrow. I believe they still have those at Onondaga Community College if you want to check out some good high school baseball. CBA is an absolute just monster. I didn't see West Hill on here. I got to see when they last played because I interviewed their head coach, Teddy Clam, a few weeks ago. Very good guy. I want to see how they did in sectionals. Let's see. West Hill. They beat Lowville 16-2 in the quarterfinals on Thursday. Did I just miss them? Are they playing today? Am I an idiot? I just missed it. They were the top game. They started noon. They're in the semifinals against Utica Notre Dame.
Sure.
Towards your temporary neck of the woods, Utica.
Utica. Come on.
West Hill was an absolute wagon this year in terms of baseball because when I interviewed the coach, they were undefeated. I'm going to double check that right now. They ended up going 19-2 on the season. That includes their, I believe that includes their sectional games. So they ended up beating Mexico, beating Lowville. The only two games they lost were to Baldwinsville and CBA, who both play two classes ahead of them. They're class double A. Those two teams are class double A. And
solid year.
Yeah, so in West Hills class B. So when your two losses come to teams that have bigger, stronger guys and play better competition most of the time, they even beat a double A team. They beat Syracuse, who I also interviewed their head coach, Mike Miola, my old coach. They beat Syracuse 19-11. So an absolute shootout there. But how about this? They played Hannibal.
Yeah, okay. Hannibal?
Yes.
I got towed from Hannibal once.
You got towed from Hannibal
once?
Yeah,
I broke down in Hannibal
once. Oh, boy. Well, Hannibal finished the year 1-14.
That's a tough year.
Take a guess what the final score of this game was.
Is there a mercy rule? There's
no
mercy rule.
No. No mercy rule.
I'm going to go with 24-2.
33-0.
I could have never guessed. What are we talking about? When do you stop?
33-0. Yeah.
You probably pull your guys. Those are all backups doing that, right? I mean, you don't start your best guy against Hannibal. You don't.
Yeah.
I mean, that's just.
That's absolutely.
That's
wild.
I try and put myself in that scenario. If I was a high schooler on that team
and
I'm losing, you know, it's the sixth inning. I go out there. We're down 29-0.
Yeah.
What am I doing? I got to be so mad. Or at that point, I've given up. Who cares? Balls go by me. I stand there. Nothing happens. Who cares?
You're the little leaguer out in right field picking daisies.
Yeah. I'm digging a hole. What's going on? They never put a guy like me on the outfield. I'm playing first base.
DH.
I'm sitting on the bag the entire time.
Yep.
A ball goes by me. It's gone.
You're holding people on when the bases are empty. You're
Throw over.
Yeah, come on. Yeah, give
practice
me the ball.
Your pick off.
You'd be a great practice first baseman. Oh, never get into the game, but you're just standing on the base.
That's what I did most of my career.
Yeah.
Practice first base.
Practice.
a lot of practice.
You were the best left bench player the Rochester area has ever seen.
Oh, yeah.
I do want to mention, because the farm team, the AAA team for your Cincinnati Reds, you're currently here in Syracuse.
Yeah.
Ellie De La Cruz is unreal at baseball.
Only because of his age did he not get called up this last time instead of Matt McClain.
Yeah.
For the Reds. Reds have
seven shortstop prospects?
Yes.
Yeah.
I mean, overwhelming number of infielders.
Mm-hmm.
What that ultimately means is that, you know, guys get pushed out, but that's fine. Ellie De La Cruz is one of the most electrifying prospects. I mean, we've seen, which the Reds are used to that the last couple of years, meaning with Hunter Green was like the big buzz.
Mm-hmm.
Now Cruz two nights ago hits a 450-foot home run.
Yeah.
And then yesterday
over the scoreboard at NBT Bank Stadium,
which is a mile out there.
Yeah. Have you been to a NBT Bank Stadium? Have you gone to a game?
I've never been.
Okay. We gotta get you to a game one of these days. And that scoreboard is not small.
Yeah.
That is a large scoreboard out there in left field. Cleared it.
Well, then I'm pretty sure he gunned somebody at the plate. He threw it. They said he threw it like 98 miles an hour.
Yeah, he's got a ridiculous arm.
Rocket.
Yeah, absolutely right. I mean, this dude's been so much fun to watch here in Syracuse. He's been killing us. You know, as a producer for the Syracuse Mets, I'm sitting here in the boot. I'm sitting here in the studio, and I was working the game when he hit that 450-foot shot.
Yeah.
And I ended up seeing the video after, and Evan Stockton was on the call, and he was just in awe. In absolute awe of this home run he hit.
You don't know what to say. I mean,
yeah,
it's so tough, especially in the Reds position, to talk about like when to bring that guy up.
Yeah.
Like a lot of prospects like that, too. Now would be the Mets. The Mets deal with that, though, right? Like they've had very good prospects the last 2 years, right?
Yeah, but there were three of the four are all up with the big club now.
Right.
They all got Brett Beatty, Francisco Alvarez, and Mark Vientos have all been called up.
Right.
So they're all with the big club now. They all started the year in Syracuse. We've got one left down here, Ronnie Mauricio.
So they're going for it.
Yeah,
the Mets are in full win mode.
Yeah, absolutely. But
yeah, the Reds haven't been in full win mode since the 90s. I mean.
No, dude.
2012.
Yeah, I was gonna say you had the early 2010s with Cueto and Jay Bruce. Yeah, that crew was BP. That dude BP. One of your favorites.
And the worst of the infield was the shortstop. I mean, thrown around between Paul Janish.
Yeah,
and
Zach Cozart. Cozart was there for a little bit.
Yeah, it was that side was the worst side of the infield.
Scott Rowland was hitting some big.
Pretty sure he won a gold glove.
Yeah, he did. Yeah, he did. He was like 38 years old, and he was still the best defensive third baseman in the National League. All right, that's Reds talk.
Yeah,
I figured it was going to happen at some point. But Ellie De La Cruz, if you haven't been out to MBT Bank Stadium, talk about perfect golf weather. It's perfect baseball weather right now. Games today, tomorrow, or Monday they're in Rochester. So today and tomorrow. Both games at 6:35. Fireworks
tomorrow.
Yeah, fireworks after the game. So it's both evening games. I'll be here in studio for the game tonight, and it's going to be an absolute gorgeous weekend for Syracuse Mets baseball. So make sure to make it out to the ballpark for our Memorial Day weekend celebration going on right now at the historic NBT Bank Stadium. I can do an ad read.
Excellent.
That's not even an ad. I just work for the
hire this guy.
Yeah, of course we are the official station of the Syracuse Mets. So I almost said New York Mets. That would have been nice. We are the official home of the Syracuse Mets. Mm-hmm. So we got to plug them whenever I can. And more plugs probably coming up after this short timeout. We're going to take a break. When we come back, a lot more to talk about here on Outside the Box Score with me, Mark Rowlands, your home for local sports in Syracuse, right here on the Score 1260.
Prospects.
Yeah, I mean, the bats are kind of stacked right now. There's a Encarnacion Strand, I think is his name.
Yep. He was a guy in spring training who hit like 6 home runs.
Yeah, that's right. He was lighting it up in spring training. Yeah, he's been hitting the ball
another infield prospect. I believe he's also a shortstop.
Yeah, I think he is.
You just trade these. They have to move. Senzel, he's not playing third anymore.
No.
One of these kids is going to play third.
Yeah.
They're going to get
Senzel's been playing a lot of center, right?
Well, this year he's been third baseman.
Oh, he has been third
pretty
baseman?
Pretty much an everyday third baseman.
Yeah, I remember.
Since he's been healthy.
Yeah, I remember when he came up, it was like, what positions this guy going to play? Center, shortstop, second base, third.
Yeah. He can play anywhere, a lot of guys can these days. Also, I had a question. I've been watching, as I bore myself at home now, laid off forever.
Yeah.
I've been watching Reds games the last 2 days. Are guys faster now or – I feel like there's more infield hits than ever before. A lot of like I saw one hit yesterday, and now again, McLean, young kid, fast, wherever. Ball hit down the third baseline, dives, grabs it, and just throws one hopper in the dirt over. So bad throw, whatever, maybe, but he was clearly going to make it.
Yeah.
Like, what is that? Is kids just faster? I feel like web gems happen constantly at third base when I grew up. Like,
yeah, a lot of athleticism
nowadays.
Like, there's just guys are so athletic now. And,
texting my pops here about Sabres talk. I mean, I'm like, who's it? He's like, oh, the Sabres signed this guy. I'm like, who's that? And he goes, he's a second round pick from last year. He's a big defensive prospect. I'm like,
if he was a second round pick last year, why is he available?
For the Sabres, like to sign.
Oh,
because they
go
back and they play college.
Right? Oh, yeah, that's right. Signed, oh, okay. I forget that hockey's weird with the draft.
But it's different. I mean, because the Sabres, Cal Peterson, the goalie for the Kings, who won back-to-back, like, best goalie in college things, whatever, he was drafted by the Sabres. And, you know, he didn't want to play. He moves on because people don't want to play for the Sabres. Now, it's crazy. You get a couple wins, get a couple young guys, people want to play. It's nice.
Yeah, that's why it's, like, partially why it's hard for me to get into hockey. It's so hard to follow players. Like, unless you're like an Eichel a McDavid.
What I was yelling about, the old man yells at Sky, the other day when Bettman was on NHL going to the playoffs, and he's like, yeah, you know, it's tough with Sidney Crosby and Alex Ovechkin. Who cares? Why are you talking about Sidney Crosby and Alex Ovechkin? Connor McDavid is in the playoffs.
Yeah.
That's the future. And they're like, well, young
he's
guy.
Already the best player in the NHL.
Greeny asks the question of like, oh, you know, can you see Connor McDavid becoming the face of the NHL? He is the face of the NHL. The NHL is behind the times, and that's why they suck at baseball. Is fantastic at it. Before Ohtani even, they're pretty good at it.
Yeah, it depends
the
on
NBA
who it is.
Is great.
Yeah. The NBA is the best at
the marker.
It. Yeah,
football tries, but the owners still have so much power they won't let the players get there. But baseball is getting better at it. I mean, you got people from Japan come over now. You know them before they even touch a baseball field in the States. Like, people don't even see Ohtani play in most people.
Yeah,
I mean, you'll watch them. You'll whatever.
Yeah,
Yoshida, these guys. They come over as superstars already.
Yeah.
If Ohtani sucked, I mean, yeah, he could have just duped people. Mm-hmm. I mean, people in the organization know it, whatever. Obviously, they that's their jobs. Yeah. But like me, who's this guy from Japan?
Yeah,
players are massive superstars. The NHL sucks.
Yeah, it's so hard to follow players in the NHL because they really don't do a good job.
They're pushing an aging game, and not for nothing. It's not like both those teams didn't even make the playoffs. That's what he kind of said too. But like,
yeah.
Are you saying that if Ovechkin had made the playoffs, we'd see more Capitals games on Monday night? You had the Bruins push the best record in hockey this year. What about Pasternak? Yeah. What about these guys? Push somebody else.
Also,
I don't even like the Bruins, but God, pick somebody.
Ovechkin, like, before the Caps won a title,
he was already not the face. He's just like, chasing goals. I love Ovechkin. He's great. Did what he did for the game. He's only a guy now that we look for home run stats. Or like, he'd be like the guy in baseball who's like, well, can he get this?
And we're back outside the box score with me, Mark Rowlands, right here on the Score 1260, your home for local sports in Syracuse. Special guest Josh Boehme joining me in studio today.
Hey.
We were just talking, you know, the sport I hardly ever talk, hockey, in the break. And we were just having a discussion about how the NHL is very bad at promoting their players.
Yeah, I don't understand it. I mean, you got the commissioner of the league promoting guys who are well past their prime.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, yes, Crosby, Ovechkin carried the game for a decade.
Yeah.
Obviously, great impact on the game. But what are we talking about here? You got guys like Connor McDavid
who
barely get screen time. They're out in Edmonton. I know it's hard to put them on prime time a lot of times or whatever. But, like, promote your young guys. They're the worst of the four major sports at promoting young guys.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
And especially, like, I know it's hard to get Edmonton in prime time or whatever, but he is the best player in hockey.
Unless you ask an Avalanche fan who's going to tell you it's McKinnon, it's undoubtedly Connor McDavid.
It's undoubtedly Connor McDavid.
Yes.
And it's been that way for like 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
It's not like this is like, oh, Connor McDavid finally burst onto the scene. He was great as a rookie. He was great his first couple of years, and then he just got better. So
he kills Sabres fans' hearts every time. Every time he does it, you just wish the lottery.
That lottery was and Eichel was good.
He could win a chip.
Yeah.
He could win a ring this year.
Yeah, he
was going to infuriate me even more. Yes.
Yeah, but I mean, he was good as a Saber. He just wasn't Connor McDavid.
He wasn't healthy either.
Yeah, that's but when he played though, he was
It's
just
a great rookie season.
Yeah, you're just not Connor McDavid.
Yeah, and you'll always be too, and it sucks.
Yeah,
because he could be great, but Connor McDavid's so good, it makes you think. Like, I remember when I first got into hockey, you're learning, and you see like Gretzky's stats, you're like, wow, that guy scored 200 points in a season. You're like, that's impossible. Nobody's ever gonna do it. And then McDavid goes out and scores 165 this year, and you're like, could he have gotten to 200? Could he get to 200? Like, you start to think about all the records and all the stats, and that, like, this guy's that good.
Yeah.
He's literally that good. I don't care about the kind of comparisons, the great one, this, that. He is that good of an offensive freak.
Yeah, he is. He's unreal. And I'm, like, very much not a hockey fan.
Sure.
But I've seen a few Edmonton games this year, and I'm like, this guy's just
on another level.
You should
just tune in just to watch his shifts.
He'll
play a third of the game and just watch that guy.
Mm-hmm. Oh, Jim, looks like Jim's heading out. Enjoy the long weekend. Be safe. Yep. Enjoy the holiday weekend, Jim. It's been a pleasure as always.
Get some holes in.
Yeah, get a couple of rounds of golf. Mm-hmm. And like I said, I'll be playing tomorrow at 11:30 at Green Lakes. I'm very excited. It's a great course. We should go out there sometime. We got to play more courses around
here.
I'm
always good.
Yeah.
Invite me out.
Yeah, whenever you're in town.
Next week?
Yeah, next week. Next week we'll see if we can get 18 holes in or something.
Sure.
Maybe grab a beverage after.
Mark, I don't know if you want me directed, but the Celtics play tonight. Your Celtics.
The Celtics do play tonight. We'll get into that. We've got one more break we've got to take.
Okay.
So we'll get into that after the break. We'll talk about my Boston Celtics here on Outside the Box Score with me, Mark Rowlands. Your home for local sports in Syracuse, right here on the Score 1260. Yeah, it's.
You don't seem to.
We'll see. I'm trying not to get my hopes up too high.
Hear me out. I don't think it's tonight. I think it's game seven. I think Miami could win game seven.
But you think it's going to be a game seven?
I think so. I don't know what – I mean, it's kind of like – and not to, you know, talk about it now and not there, but, like, it's kind of like I don't know what it is. They sit their starters in the entirety of the fourth.
Yeah.
Which make – No goddamn sense to me. I don't care in anything. You're in the playoffs. The Suns did it in the Nuggets series, too, when they were down in game two. And they sat them for the entirety. And I'm like, unless they're playing, the only time I get it is the Lakers. Like, because they're old and they're always injured. And it's like, we don't even want to deal with it.
Yeah.
But even then, it's like, let your starters go in there for 4 or 5 minutes. See if they can go on a run.
Yeah.
Like, you're only down, and it sounds stupid to say, but you're down 17 going into the fourth. Right?
Which is nothing in the NBA.
Right. You go on a 10-0 run, you're right back in the game. So, like, why don't you let the guys see if they got it? I don't know. It's silly to me, but we'll see. I Spoelstra's been, all the credit he got for the first three games should get all of the negative the last two. To not close out in game four.
Yeah.
And then sit the guys in game five, go lose by double digits. All the momentum has swung.
It's all the way the Celtics right
everyone
now.
Everyone is dreaming about Boston.
I'm just seeing, you know, John Boehme, MLB gambling guy. Yeah, he came on our gambling show once.
Yeah. He said he's terrible these days.
Yeah, I'm just seeing his do not subscribe for my picks right now. Right. He says, like, oh man. He hasn't been giving me too many winners when we interview him on the Man Child show. But
you follow what you ride? You're a rider.
Oh, yeah. We ask him for picks every time we interview him. And I always ride his picks. And hasn't been great recently. Love John. He'll get it back. He's way too good of a gambler to not get it back. But
there's this guy on, like, gambling Twitter who tweeted out after game three, or going into game four, he tweeted out Celtics money line, Celtics in seven. And he tweeted it. And some guy was like, quote tweeted, it was like, this is how people make money on the book. Like, this is how the books make money.
Yeah.
It's like this. The guy since blocked him because, of course, they won. He's like, this guy. And he's going crazy, whatever. And now, just today, he's like, two games left for our legacy. And I'm like, dude, even then, that's the craziest thing. Not for nothing. When it was 3-0, the Celtics were plus 800 to win the series.
Yes. Not nearly.
Astronomically low.
Yeah. Not nearly high enough.
Because they were talking about nobody's ever come back from 3-0. How many teams have been in that position who were like minus 600 to win the series?
Yeah.
Not many. The best team in the East, arguably, with Milwaukee, whatever.
I mean,
who, you know, the Heat have just beaten anyways.
Yeah.
Oh, it's going to be weird, too, that if they close it out now, I think the Knicks have been six, too, so never mind. It would have been all the same for them, but.
Yeah.
We'll see.
Screw it. I just cut, like, a minute and a half of commercials.
Oh, okay. Sure.
And we're back outside the box score with me, Mark Rowlands, right here on the Score 1260, your home for local sports in Syracuse. Josh, I'm thinking, first we're going to talk about my Celtics. And all I'm going to say is, I think it might be happening.
You think so?
I think A-Rod and Derek Jeter going to game four cursed the Miami Heat.
Okay.
Because why would they do that?
Known
blower of a 3-0 lead to a Boston team.
Historic.
In the league championship.
You think that the stars are aligning?
I think the stars are aligning. And that's going to lead me to something I want to talk about.
Okay.
Very quickly. Boston's a 3-point favorite tonight.
In Miami.
In Miami.
Yeah.
And I love it.
I mean, if you love Boston, you love the points, right? I mean, what do the points matter? I was with a guy who was strongly convinced that 8 was too many last game.
Yeah.
Now it's 3 and they're home. And I don't know. I've been out of it for a little. Like, I don't know how to think about it. I really don't. It's a tricky game. I love the live bet strategy. You talked about it on here last week. You know, live betting's great. You can hop in at halftime. If someone's up 20, they'll give you a good points. Hop in there. It's going to be a close game for sure. I don't see anyone winning by 10 or more. I don't see that.
Yeah, probably not after the last two games, though.
I can see it being tight, but even then, the entirety of the momentum is in Boston's hands.
All of it.
They look hot. They came out hot last game. If Jaylen Brown figures out how to shoot, this thing's going to be a rout.
Yeah.
I mean, he's been gone. I don't know what happened to that guy, this conference finals.
Yeah, well,
he's playing good elsewhere.
He's playing
but
decent, but no, he can't.
Which is odd.
He'll get it back, and I'm not too worried, but it just leads me. The inception of the show was gambling.
Yeah.
We were talking about it earlier.
Sure.
Dodgers money line.
I like that.
I like it.
Glasnow's first start.
Glasnow's first start. Kershaw on the mound. Kershaw having a very Kershaw year. ERA under 3 once again. Guy's an absolute absolute stud. And yeah, so I was hoping we don't have really much time anymore to look at the slate, sadly. Yeah. I was hoping we would be able to take a look at the baseball slate today and maybe see what we like. But I also don't hate Padres' money line against the Yankees tonight.
Okay.
Luis Severino's on the mound against Michael Wacha. I don't know why. I've just got a feeling. Anyway, that'll wrap things up for this edition of Outside the Box Score. With me, Mark Rowlands. Josh, thank you so much for joining.
Thanks for having me.
Absolute blast, as always. We'll be back next week, same time, same channel, 11 a.m. right here on the Score 1260. Peace. All right, folks, over on the Twitch and YouTube side, thank you for joining. We'll see you next week. Shout out Josh. Follow him on Twitter, at OGBojo42. He's very funny. I meant to do that on the actual show. God damn it. But yeah, we'll see you next week. Peace.